क्लास 9 इंग्लिश रीडिंग यूनिट 8 गाजीज़ डायरी। गाजी लव राइटिंग अबाउट हिज फीलिंग्स एंड एक्सपीरियंसेस। ही ऑफन रोट थिंग्स इन हिज डायरी व्हेन एवर ही गॉट इनटू द राइटिंग मूड। द फॉलोइंग आर टू पेजेस फ्रॉम हिज डायरी। विलेज लाइफ। टुडे आई एम वंस अगेन रिमाइंडेड of my simple village and its loving and caring people. I am living in Karachi now, in a beautiful house that has many modern facilities. It is located in a locality that has clean streets and big houses that have beautiful gardens with a variety of plants and trees. But I am desperately missing my village, desperately. The simple mud houses that we lived in, the simple toys that gave us so much pleasure, and the simple carefree people amongst whom we lived. I wish I could get into a time machine and go back 60 years back to my life in the village. The house that we lived in had three rooms and a kitchen, all spread out in a yard that had no boundary, just some bushes separating our property from that of our neighbors. My grandparents and two of my unmarried aunts lived in one room, my parents and siblings lived in another room, while my uncle and his family lived in the third room. We had a common kitchen where the woman of the family cooked for all of us. The house in which I now live is made of cement and painted in beautiful colors with tiled floors. However, the houses in our village were all made of wood, straw and mud. We had no furniture as much. We sat on the floor and slept on the floor by spreading some quilts that were kept on a wooden stand during the day. Quilts. This was probably why very few people had knee problems. People of all ages comfortably sat on the floor, which exercised their knees. Our village did not have roads and streets. There were just narrow mud lanes, which became very slippery during the rainy season. Commuting from one place to another was not an issue. People did not need cars, buses, or even motorbikes to go from one place to another in the village. They just walked. All this exercise kept them healthy, and the absence of motor vehicles kept the environment pollution free. Unlike the city, the village did not have big shops and supermarkets. There were just a few small shops selling goods that people needed for everyday living. One did not always need money or credit cards to buy things from these shops. One could buy things from these shops even if one did not have any money, because the village shopkeepers knew everyone by name and were usually willing to give goods on credit. The village otak, the place where man met in the evening, was where men spent their free time, shared news and gossips, laughed at shared jokes, talked about the weather, their crops and village issues, and enjoyed folk songs sung to the tune of the घाघर एंड तंबूरा, घाघर एंड तंबूरा। द वूमेन हैड द विलेज वेल विच वॉज द सेंटर ऑफ ऑल देयर एक्टिविटीज़। द विलेज मैन एंड वूमेन शेयर्ड देयर न्यूज़ एंड इशूज़ विद पीपल एंड इन्जॉयड ईच अदर्स कंपनी। दे डिड नॉट गेट देयर न्यूज़ फ्रॉम द टेलीविजन, लर्न अबाउट वाट वॉज हैपनिंग विद पीपल फ्रॉम द फेसबुक, गेट देयर इंटरटेनमेंट फ्रॉम द यूट्यूब एंड टॉक टू पीपल सिटिंग एट द नेक्स्ट टेबल थ्रू SMS और ईमेल। ऑल देयर एक्टिविटीज सेंटर्ड ऑन पीपल इन द फ्लैश एंड ब्लड, नॉट पीपल वाया डिवाइसेस। अलास, आर लग्जरियस लाइफ स्टाइल हैज़ कॉम्प्रोमाइज्ड आर हेल्थ। लग्जरियस लाइफ स्टाइल कॉम्प्रोमाइज्ड। द अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ डिवाइसेस हैज़ डिस्टेंस्ड अस फ्रॉम पीपल। द एक्सेस टू टेक्नोलॉजी हैज़ रिप्लेस्ड द ह्यूमन टच। आई विश फॉर अ टाइम मशीन टू टेक मी बैक टू माई सिंपल लाइफ। सिंपल पीपल, सिंपल इंटरेस्ट एंड सिंपल वॉन्ट्स एंड नीड्स। वी नीड टू स्टोर रेन वाटर। मूनसूनस वंस अगेन, फ्लूड्स एवरीवेयर, द मच नीडेड रेन इज हेयर। वाइल वाटर इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट नीड ऑफ लाइफ, टू मच ऑफ इट कैन कॉज फ्लूडिंग एंड डिवास्टेशन इन पाकिस्तान। फ्लूड्स क्रिएट हैवॉक व्हेन रिवर्स ओवरफ्लो देयर बैंक्स ड्यूरिंग द मूनसून सीजन। रिवर्स हैव ऑलवेज प्लेड अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल इन द लाइफ ऑफ ह्यूमन बीइंग्स। दे हैव सर्व्ड एज ट्रेड रूट्स फ्रॉम द अर्लीस्ट ऑफ टाइम्स। बिफोर द बिल्डिंग ऑफ रोड्स एंड रेलवेज, मोस्ट ट्रेड वॉज कैरिड on by boats and ships along rivers. In addition to this, rivers have been important for growing food. This was the reason that most towns in ancient times were built near rivers. However, rivers flood during the rainy season and run dry or have very little water sometime after the rain. One way that people have found to capture and retain the rainwater for later use is by building structures to hold the water and prevent it from flooding. This way, the retained water can be used throughout the year for growing food. One way in which water is stored is through barrages built on rivers. Barrages. A barrage is a kind of wall which blocks the flow of water. It has gates through which the water is allowed to pass in a limited quantity. Its aim is to control the flow of water in the flood season, store it and release it for irrigation through the canals throughout the year. The Guddu barrage built on the river Indus is one of the many barrages built in Pakistan. It is built at a place where the river is 14 km in width. It is designed to force the water spread over 14 km to pass through a narrow barrage about 1 kilometer wide. The barrage is 1355 kilometers in length. It is made in such a way that a flood of about 1.2 million cusacks can pass through it. Cusacks. The Guddu barrage was a system of three main canals. Two of these are on the right bank and one on the left. The Begari Singh feeder and the desert part feeder. The Begari Singh feeder and the desert part feeder आर ऑन द राइट बैंक. द थर्ड कनाल द घोटकी फीडर. घोटकी फीडर इज ऑन द लेफ्ट बैंक. द थ्री कनाल्स आर अमंगस्ट द लार्जेस्ट फीडर कनाल्स इन द वर्ल्ड. द बराज इज मीन टू इरीगेट एन एरिया ऑफ 2.7 million acres. Most of this area lies in the Sakhar and Jacobabad district of Sindh. Jacobabad districts of Sindh and the rest in the Kalat division of the Balochistan province. The Guddu Barrage is one of the biggest barrages of Pakistan. It has also been the most difficult to complete. More than 5,000 engineers, technicians and laborers worked day and night to complete it. It was put into operation on 4th February 1962. The barrage has tamed the river and put an end to the damage caused by floods in this area. It is about time that the government started constructing more barrages to control flooding during the rainy season and to supply water throughout the year for irrigating more land so that Pakistan becomes self-sufficient in meeting its demands for grains, fruits and vegetables. In fact, proper water management can allow us to grow surplus food items which we can then export and earn foreign exchange.